Greetings, this is Daniel Presedo for Adobe Photoshop, and welcome to my YouTube channel. I had a question come up on my YouTube channel about saving 3D textures inside Photoshop, you know, on your 3D model. Here's how you can do it. This is a regular 3D model, it's an OBJ file I imported. I'm going to click once to select this model, and it'll show you, if you bring up the properties under Windows Properties here, with the 3D panel also out here, you will see that it selected the mesh of the thing model here, this 3D model, and the properties therein. If I click on it again, it's going to bring up the material. So I can click on the model and cycle through between mesh and material. So once I've selected this material, I can open its properties, I can edit them, I can change UV properties, even replace the texture if I want. And now, if this model, this has only one diffuse texture, but if it had multiple, if you click on the areas, for example, if the pants were a separate texture, I could click on it here and it would select, the second click here, it would select the materials for the pants. In this case, this is one mesh with one texture. So I'm going to go ahead and show you. Once you have this selected, as we do here, cycle mesh, cycle to material, you can open it, edit texture here. You can also select under the diffuse here and double click this layer file, this mesh texture, diffuse texture. It'll open up the smart object. A smart object is an object that is inside the PSD. It's held inside the PSD, so you don't have to worry about losing it or carrying it around. You know, it's not lost luggage. It's inside your PSD, which makes it convenient, especially for 3D models that have multiple files attached to them. So again, I'm going to go ahead and close this. I'm not going to save it. You can also open it from here in the Properties panel, Edit Texture. Let's go and rearrange our windows and tile them vertically here. And you can treat this like any file. So now if I wanted to save this diffuse texture out, I can save it out as simple as save as a JPEG, for example, or export PNG, save for web. I can export it like I would any Photoshop file. And in fact, I can change it. For example, I'm just going to invert it here and save it. It'll update the 3D model there. Now I can go ahead and invert it again. You could add layers to this file. You can do anything you would normally do with an image file inside Photoshop. Let's go ahead and save it again. And it's reverting back to that, even with the two layers. So if I close it, let's go ahead and close it. I'm going to go ahead and select the model. This is the mesh. Select it again, material. Open that texture. And you'll see the two layers are still there. And I can export this, save as a JPEG again, and export it. And I can use that diffuse texture on other projects if that's what I want to do. You can also export the 3D layer. So if I wanted to export this object, it'll export the mesh along with those textures. For example, I'm going to choose the OBJ format here, and I have all these formats to choose from to save my image files, my textures, and materials. So that is another way to save the images out. So I hope that answers the questions. If you have additional ones, please leave them on the channel, and I appreciate you watching, and thank you for watching. On to the next video.